Okay, thank you. Thank you, John. I'm so glad to see you again and again. And also thank you, Mr. Martin Jia, and also Mr. Vijay. So because of you, both of you and also Mr. John Lowe's support, four of us cooperate and publish our four articles, long articles in a very famous Chinese academic journal, the Northeast Asia Forum. This this journal is one of the top three international relations journal in China, and which has a very great influence on Chinese academic circles. And so today, four of us will share our views, our visions about the new Cold War. And also, not only in China, through a lot of very important platforms simultaneously, and also on the YouTube platform. And I know Martin and John and Vijian, you will share your views. So I would like to share my views on New Cold War about the research report. Just a very, very brief four points. First, is so-called, so we all know that the American election nowadays is generally over finished, and Mr. Joe Biden will be win over 99%. But we look at the last 1 year, nearly 1 year, they both of them, Mr. Trump and Mr. Joe Biden, they wanted to play the China card, but now we can know that so-called China card planned by the two presidential candidates did not work. In particular, President Trump. So every day, President Trump criticized China. He tried to divert voters' attention from his feeling to fight the pandemic and hoping to create an enemy of China to unite the American society. And China, you know, on China's side, China is not fooled. China did not become the number one topic before the election day. We all know, right? The first topic in the past 1 year in the election process is the new coronavirus and the personal scandal of the two candidates. And China has not launched a first battle with the US. Instead, it has reacted politely and it's not willing to lead the focus of the American public opinion. At the same time, there are too many domestic problems in the US, including political infighting, economic recession, social disintegration, and discrimination, and out of the control of pandemic situation as well. There are a lot of problems, domestic problems in US. So this fully shows that the general election strategy of playing the China card has failed, right? That's the first point I want to share. Second point is that President Trump's strategy of trying to find a new Cold War with China also failed. According to the four standards of the definition of the Cold War in the international academic circle, they are first, all around the confrontation. Second, ideological opposition. Third, two camps. And fourth, the decoupling of the economy. But at present, till now, the state of the China and the United States is far from the new Cold War. Despite the Trump every day pointing at China, China has maintained restraint, except for the foreign ministry forced response. Chinese leader, including our President Xi Jinping and our Prime Minister Ke Qiang, have been silent to the US. So this is not to dare, but to have some strategic thinking and not to fall into a new Cold War. So instead, China has been calling for cooperation between the two countries. So and also, fortunately, the two societies have been cooperating. The trade between China and the U.S. in the last 10 months, growing year on year, better than that in 2019. And the count of the capital IPO raised by Chinese company going to the U.S., going to New York for listing in the first 8 months exceeds the total amount in 2019. And the U.S. assets, such as Goldman Sachs, Morgan Stanley, J.P. Morgan, also have more holdings in the China's financial market than in 2019. So behind this lies Chinese strategy of comprehensively deepening reform and opening up and the attraction of the China market. So I think that China society level and U.S. society level, we cooperate very deeply. More than last year, more than before. That's the second point I want to share. The third point I want to share is that, yes, we prepared. We have a psychologically preparation. China-US friction will become the new normal in the next 10 years or more. So I call it competition and cooperation. And China has made adequately psychologically prepared, as I said. And China can understand American anxiety because China economic growth, China rise up very, very quickly. And a lot of think tank and institute, they estimate that maybe in 5 years or in 7 years, at most in 10 years, China's GDP will surpass US. And but the problem is that time will prove that China don't want to replace US leadership. So I think that some scholar, they often use a Huxley trap to copy the game between China and the United States, want to describe the relationship between China and the US. But I think for the United States, rather than worry about the China rise leading to the decline of the US. So I think it's better for United States, it's better to reflect on why the United States have been engaged in foreign wars for 90% of the time since its founding, especially in recent years. So I think that if we remember that in 2015, President Xi Jinping visited the United States. He said, we should all try to avoid falling into the Huxley trap. And the idea that a powerful nation can only pursue hegemony does not apply to China. China has no implemented the gene for such an action. I think this sentence is very, very important. President Xi Jinping promised, we don't want to replace the United States. But I think this is a very, very important statement. That's the third point I want to share. Fourth point, the last point, last but not least, is that in the future competition between China and the US is how to govern their own country and meet the needs of their people for a better life. That is the competition for domestic governance. If we look at the last 1 year, nearly 1 year, China tried our best to control basically, fundamentally, the pandemic spreading. And only in 2 months. Nowadays, China basically recovering our daily life, the Chinese. But look at the United States. Over more than 200,000 people have died, more than all the world's deaths since the World War II. So I think we should focus our domestic solution, both of us. Nowadays, if my foreign friends know, China, just last week, China has passed and finished its 14th five-year plan and set a long-term goal for 2035 in the coming 15 years. And in the context of this plan, I read all the documents of the five-year plan and also the long-term goal for 2035. There are no any special mention about United States. Instead, in the documents, they focus on the domestic fields, such as economy, society, development, and people, livelihood, and science, innovation, and technology development, and security, something like that. About the foreign policy, the documents expressed the idea of the opening up with a high quality and building a new type of the international relations and promote the construction of the community of shared future for mankind. No any mentions about US. This is true. Very long document, very long draft. So I think it can be seen that in the views of the Chinese decision maker, it is not China established strategic goals to compete with the US. If it is necessary to construct a future of competition between US and Europe and China, the key to who can win in the competition in the future is not to create a new Cold War and try to win, but also who can better create a better society and help the world build a better future. I think this is a key for the future competition between China and the US. And for me, a China think tank scholar, I will try my country to promote the social development and also help the world build a better future. I think if we can do it, China can do that. We will win for the future. And not we don't want to have any new Cold War with US. So this is my part of my research report and my views on new Cold War. Thank you again and again. Thank you, John. Thank you, everybody, my foreign friends. Thank you.